Requestly is an open source solution for mocking and testing APIs. In this video, we will show how developers make local API development, mocking and testing 10x faster. Let's quickly see how we can set up Requestly and intercept API traffic from web and mobile apps. Once you download and install Requestly desktop app, simply click on Connect Apps button to intercept API traffic. You can connect to the installed browsers, mobile devices, emulators, and desktop applications. Let's connect to the existing Google Chrome profile. You need Requestly Chrome extension to connect the Chrome browser and the desktop app. Once the Chrome browser is connected to Requestly, all the HTTP traffic of the Chrome browser will be intercepted and visible. Now, we have access to all the API traffic of my Chrome browser. Next, we will look at how Requestly can be used to mock the APIs. To demonstrate how to mock an API, just find the API request and select the Modify Response Body option. You can choose whether it is a REST API, GraphQL API, or static content like HTML or JavaScript. You can override by providing static data, or you can use simple JavaScript code for dynamic override. You can also provide a mock response from a file on your system. In this demo, I'll be overriding using static data. On saving the rule and reloading the site, I can see that the response is now being served by Requestly. The same API request now turns green in the traffic table. This indicates that a rule has been applied and the mock response was served. Requestly reduces collaboration friction between front-end and back-end teams. Front-end developers can continue to build features against API mocks when back-end APIs are either unreliable or not ready. Let's configure a mock for a non-existent or fake API endpoint. Go to HTTP Rules from Side Pane, click on New Rule, and select the Modify Response option. Choose the REST API and provide the API URL where the mock response should be served. This is a fake endpoint, and it returns a 404. Now let's define the mock response. Now, when we hit this API, it looks like the API is working and returning the mock response configured in Requestly. Let's take a look how you can use Requestly for building and testing APIs. Requestly has extensive API testing capabilities, which can be accessed through the API client. You can send requests to an endpoint, attach query parameters, body, and headers. I'll send the default request, and this is how the response body and headers look like. All the sent requests are visible in the history. You can use API collections to organize and arrange the different API requests. Let's quickly explore a couple of API endpoints within OpenAI's collection. In this API request, the authorization header containing OpenAI key is picked from an environment variable. You can create multiple environments and define a list of key value pairs under each environment. Environments can be switched easily from this dropdown. Let's explore the bulk API mocking capability that lets you mock an entire flow. Using this, you can record API traffic from one environment, create mocks for the API traffic, and use the API mocks in local development. For the demo, we have the search flights flow recorded from the eDreams.com site. This set of network requests is triggered when a flight search happens. Now, considering a scenario where the GraphQL server is not up, we can actually create mocks for all the GraphQL APIs to continue development irrespective of the status of the server. Once the session is saved, click the Create Mocks button, and then select the request type to be GraphQL. Specific operation names can be specified here, but for now, let's select all the GraphQL APIs. Filtered requests are then visible. And now, create the mocks for the selected requests. Let's retrace the entire flow to see the mocks in action. And as you can see, some of these requests have turned green, which indicates that rules have been applied. These are the GraphQL requests that were mocked, quickly identifiable from the operation name visible up front. Requestly offers a lot more modification options. They can be accessed from the New Rules dropdown. You can create rules to redirect requests, replace a string from a particular URL, change the query parameters, modify the request and response body, modify headers, inject custom scripts on a web page, cancel requests, and delay network requests. Requestly offers team workspaces for seamless collaboration within the team. Use the Workspaces dropdown to join, create workspace, switch between existing workspaces, invite teammates, and manage a workspace. Team members would have access to all rules, collections, environments, and sessions. That's it. Head over to our GitHub and watch all the action as we build Requestly in public, and don't forget to star us on GitHub. Thank you for watching.